As part of the MadeSafe partnership, nearly 150 Maidstone Town Centre venues can instantly report any suspicious behaviour to the police using a shared radio network.
Police to cameras, have you still got eyes on?
No, we've gone up Church Street, can't see up there.
Door staff have alerted Carl and Gigi to a man who's been thrown out of a pub for allegedly photographing a woman without her consent.
There's been lots of reported issues with spiking and people, young females, being taken advantage of their leaving clubs. So it's a very big thing for us to try and make sure that there's nothing going on.
Over 1,300 victims in the UK have reported being spiked with an injection in the last 6 months.
Needle spiking is a really worrying trend. Definitely, people are carrying needles with them that have the chemical or drug already inside, and they will inject that into someone's back or leg, where they might not notice it until afterwards. I have dealt with victims who have been spiked on a night out. Sometimes they're in a really bad way. It's a really frightening experience for them. What was the description?
Like a 50, 60-year-old bloke, like black coat.
CCTV operators are tracking the man.
He's just past the Metro Bank now.
Yeah, we're just by Metro Bank now. You can probably see us. Which one is he?
Directly on your left, male, black jacket, blue jeans. I've lost visual of him. He's crossed over the road.
Is he up there?
Yeah, no, I think we got him. Excuse me, mate. Hello, mate. You can stop there for us. Hello, you all right? Cool.
Hello.
What I'm going to do, okay, is I'm going to detain you for the purpose of the search, okay?
For what?
Under Section 1 of the Police and Criminal Evidence Act.
Well, what then?
Okay, so you allegedly have been removed from a premises.
I've been asked to leave, yes.
Yeah, for filming a group of females, okay?
I wasn't filming.
Okay, well, that's what the allegation is. So obviously, there's a big.
Do you want to check my phone?
Yeah, we'll do that. Can you unlock it for me and I'll have a look?
There's obviously a big push on it at the minute. So what we're looking for is any items that might relate to females being spiked while they're in clubs, okay? Do you understand why you're being searched, okay? You're entitled to...
Well, I wasn't taking any photos of anybody, so...
No, that's fine, and obviously, if that's the case, then we get that, but we have to double-check these things and make sure, all right?
Kent Police definitely has a disruption method in place for people who we suspect may be involved in drink spiking. If I'm suspicious of someone's behaviour, I would always rather stop them and speak to them. Yeah, it's definitely better to be safe than sorry.
Do you have anything on you shouldn't have?
Well, I haven't got anything on.
Okay, all right. Yeah, cool. If you just keep your arms out like that.
So what's this photo of this girl then?
What girl was there?
What's that about?
I don't know.
No. Okay, so you haven't taken that photo then, no?
I haven't taken it.
Well, it looks like you have taken it because there's a photo of a girl on your phone. So obviously the reason you've been kicked out for is perfectly legitimate because they've seen you taking a photo of a young girl.
I haven't done anything wrong.
Well, it looks like you've quite specifically taken a photo of a girl, doesn't
it? I haven't taken any photo of any girl.
Sometimes it's quite obvious when someone's lying, and sometimes you have to do a bit more digging. But yeah, usually you get a feeling for whether someone is telling the truth or not, and from there you can kind of dig a bit deeper, and their story usually unravels. So this photo was taken on your phone. It even gives me an exact location of where you've taken it. So.
Look, the guy said to me that she's a nice girl. I said, what, is it this one? He went, yes.
So did you take the photo?
I don't necessarily know that I took a photo.
OK, that's changed already, isn't it?
But listen, how can you say, I'm not necessarily taking a photo, when what you've done is exactly take a photo?
Well, that's probably from when I closed the screen. I don't know.
I have no idea why you took that photograph. And that's the concern. It is really disturbing that people are doing that to females on nights out. I think it happens probably more than we realise. Again, a photograph can be taken so subtly, you might have no idea it's ever been taken, but where that photograph goes and what it's being used for is what's quite concerning.
Carl doesn't find anything to suggest the man is involved in spiking. However, the officers do have some words of advice for him.
Well, obviously, there's no criminal offence here, but we are going to take note that you are doing this.
But I've done nothing wrong.
I disagree with you. You have done something wrong.
I haven't done anything wrong.
It's predatory behaviour, isn't it? You're being a predator by taking pictures of girls who aren't consenting. Yeah. Why would they want you taking photos of them on your phone? Why would they want that?
Well, the guy said to me, she's quite nice. Look at her. I went, oh, yeah, she's quite nice. And then next thing, I've got a bouncer saying, can you leave?
And rightly so. He's done a great job, hasn't he?
Yes, I will leave.
I'm going to delete this photo.
Yeah,
and I suggest that you don't do it anymore.
Okay, no problem.
If that was a picture of me, I'd be furious. You know, it's a week before Christmas. People are out having a good time. And you don't go out expecting, you know, someone to abuse your trust like that. You know, it's not OK.
Where are you going now?
I'm going home.
OK. Taxi rank's down there if you want one.
I went back to the venue afterwards to speak to the staff, and the females were just leaving. I told them that he had taken a photo of them, and I told them that it had been deleted. Obviously, I don't know if he's stored other copies or whatever, but obviously we've done what we can on that evening to stop that photograph going any further. Good work.
He's on his phone. He's phone down. You have to take your phone.
The driver, using his phone at the wheel, has continued in the opposite direction.
You probably won't be able to catch a wheel for it.
Have we got? Should we try?
Have a 8-7-7.
Driving a vehicle using your phone is obviously a massive no-no. You're not concentrating at the wheel.
Modern cars have everything you need to be hands-free. There's really no excuse at all in my mind. It's a massive distraction, and it can cause really serious accidents if you're not paying attention.
It's going to have gone straight on,
I reckon so.
Motorists are 4 times more likely to be in a crash if they use their phone whilst driving. A closer look in a car park.
There he is.
There you go. That's the car.
And Gemma makes her second spot of the morning.
Nice one, Gemma. Yeah, we did find him hiding behind a wall and was just kind of sitting in it, hoping, I think, that we'd gone away. Hello, sir. Yeah. You know why we stopped you, don't you?
Yeah, I quit coming here to pull over to take the phone call.
The driver claims he was on his way back from a job interview when he answered a call from his agency.
Obviously, we've stopped you because you've obviously committed a traffic offence. Yeah, on your phone. Yeah, we hear lots of excuses, obviously reasons as to why you're on your phone, like you've had the job interview, you're waiting for a phone call. But unless it's a real emergency, that like there and then, life and death, if you like, there really isn't an excuse.
Like, really, if your phone rings and you're driving, you can't answer just to say, oh, I'm driving. You need to not answer at all.
People need to understand that sometimes. We're not picking on them. There's a reason that we're doing it, and we're trying to keep the roads safe.
You've got hands free.
Yeah, I know. Stuart reminded me.
Yeah.
I was getting excited.
I know. Yeah, which is fantastic. But obviously, we've got a job to do, and it is busy. So Monday morning, all right.
Gigi issues the driver with the ticket for using a mobile phone whilst driving.
Well, she is in a fine.
Yeah, there'll be a fine,
and I think
and
it's usually
points,
6 points.
6 points for it. The thing is, if you end up with 6 points for that, so plus the 3 you've got, that's not great. All right, so you might want to consider your driving. Yeah? As in, be a bit more sensible.
That's fine, that's everything, all right?
All right, OK.
Just don't do it again, yeah? Because you're putting yourself and other people in danger.
I know.
All right, see you later.
He's annoyed at us, fair enough, but... Busy Monday morning, you're in traffic, blatant on your phone.
That's how accidents happen.
No regard, yeah. If he has an accident, it goes straight into the back of someone else. And then it causes all sorts of issues as well with insurance. Someone else isn't insured, or if he didn't have insurance, he's tried to avoid us.
I'm going to ask whether he's taken any night.
Yeah, so he's upset, but at the end of the day.
The eagle-eyed Pev spotted him.
Don't know about that.
If the driver gets any more points, he will lose his licence.